And now it's time for the Coke Zero coin toss. A winning combination with Coke taste and zero calories. Vanderbilt is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He's to the 10. He's taken down at the 31. Now we'll get to see how this quarterback can do today as he comes out onto the field for the first time. The defense sets up in the nickel. And they make the stop at the 39. That's a gain of 8. We've got a second and 2. Ball on their own 39. They line up in the shotgun, 3 wide. Throws out to the running back, no good.
Number 1, the intended receiver on the play.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. This crowd is energetic, and they'd really love to see a stop right here. The senior makes the catch. They brought the house on that one.
And this kid shows a lot of poise and moxie in the pocket. He knew he was going to get hit, but he hung in there and delivered the ball with accuracy.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Throws out and through his hands. 2nd down and 10 to go.
The intended receiver on the play.
Going with the shotgun here. Gets it. He's in space. And down he goes at about the 37-yard line.
This defense was very lucky they didn't give up a home run. They blitzed both cornerbacks and only gave up a 1st and 10. Anytime both corners blitz and you fail to get to the quarterback, the offense is looking at a shot at 6 points.
1st and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Touchdown, Auburn!
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Converts the extra point. And now we'll take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Auburn to kick this one off. He kicks it off. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So now let's see how the offense responds as they take the field down 7-0.
Guys, I know it's early in this game, but this quarterback needs to step up and make a statement right now. A good drive could do wonders for his team's confidence.
He drops back. Throws it complete, and they're all over it. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Great pursuit there by the linebacker to make the sure tackle on this kid.
It's complete. Brought down at the 44.
As long as they're making completions and positive yards when they go to the air, then it can't be too bad of a play.
One man backfield. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. And that'll be good enough to move the sticks.
Great run. And now we've got a new set of downs.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46. Offset eye formation in the backfield. Here's a counter, losing yards. A great defensive effort there.
And let me tell you, the key to that play was right there in the defensive line. They tied this offensive line up and allowed their linebackers to come up and make a big play.
Lee, I agree with you. We always talk about the linebackers and safeties, but credit the big guys up front for that play.
taken down right around the 48-yard line. The slant pattern good for about 8 yards on the play.
This receiver ran a very nice route here, and the quarterback did a good job of hitting him in stride. I like it.
Back to pass. They bring the quarterback down.
That is a nice pass rush.
Yep, it was the defensive end that was able to penetrate through there and get that great sack.
Fourth down. Looks like they're going to punt it away here. He punts it.
Pretty good drive last time out for this offense, right, fellas?
They did a very good job of moving the ball forward. This defense had no answer for the offense.
And in particular, it was the passing game. This quarterback was really hot on that last drive.
Pitch out, got the corner. He just couldn't hold off the defender, and he's brought down. 7 yards there. Second and three coming up. They'll work from the shotgun. Hand off to the right. And he just got drilled. So the halfback picks up the first down there with that 6 yard gain.
This is a great run. He used a nice juke move on the play, and he picked him up a first down.
Going with the shotgun here. Makes the catch, and look out. Tackle made at the 46. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Look at that great pitch and catch. That's great stuff right there.
So the coach challenges the call, and they're going to try to determine if the receiver made the catch inbounds.
They called him inbounds on the field, but there are a whole lot of people on the defensive sideline that don't think he got a foot in.
So after the review, the verdict is that it was no catch.
They missed it on the field, but that was a bang-bang play. The important thing is they got the call right.
Auburn is up a score. And they use motion. Looks to pass. And they got him.
Outstanding job there by the linebacker. Found his way through on the blitz.
It was really just a great play by a super sophomore. I really like this kid's potential for the future.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. The defense sets up in the dime. Pass complete and taken down immediately. They picked up some yards, but it won't be enough to keep those chains moving.
They went to the right guy. He just couldn't get away.
I actually like the play call here by the offense, but the defense does a nice job of shutting it down that time. Great play recognition by the defense.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. The defense is in the nickel. Intercepted. It's the junior corner. He's got an opening. Touchdown, Auburn. And just like that, they make it a two-possession game.
They really took the pressure off themselves there. That was a great return for a touchdown, and it gives them some breathing room on defense.
Yeah, this offense has a lot of work to do now. They're really going to have to fight to get back in this ballgame.
And he hits the PAT.
It's good.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And this one's away. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
Yeah, Kirk, this game is already getting out of hand. They can't afford these turnovers.
Yeah, they need to get something going here. This team can't afford to get much of a bigger hole before halftime.
The back gets three on the carry.
3 yard gain on the play.
They come out with three wide receivers. They go with a run, and they got him for a loss.
This is a fabulous job by the linebacker of shedding a block and getting into the backfield.
Yep, the offensive line left the ball carrier out to dry there. Without better protection, he won't be able to go anywhere.
As we change ends of the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. The score here in Nashville is Auburn 14, Vanderbilt nothing. It's third and 10. Ball on their own 39. With a quick throw. And he's immediately tackled. Not too bad a pass there.
Nope, not at all. That time he puts enough air under this thing to fill that big blip up there. But somehow it came down on target, and he got a nice little gain out of it.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. They line it up with three receivers. They motion to the left. Goes to his back, and it's in and out of his hands. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 44. One man backfield. Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted.
You talk about a weapon. This defender has been all over the field today.
Well, he's giving this quarterback fits right now. That's his second interception of the day.
I think it'd be a good idea for this quarterback to avoid this corner. He has shown that he can make some very athletic plays.
They're in the shotgun with three wide receivers. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's taken down at the 38-yard line. And they execute the screen pass for a nice gain and a first down.
They ran that play to perfection. I love the way the quarterback keeps his eyes downfield while the screen develops. Not only is he freezing the safety, but he's inviting a heavy pass rush at the same time. That right there, my friend, is what happens when you run this play like it's drawn up.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 32. The quarterback's in the gun with three receivers in the set. Not to the tailback, and he dropped it. Here's a third and long situation. Ball on the 32-yard line. From the gun. He drops back. It's complete. Brought down around the 34-yard line. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
Yep, I'm not a big fan on that call there. If I was the offensive coordinator, then I'd make sure I had three receivers going down past the first down line.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
The offense has to be conscious of protecting that football.
Yeah, turnovers drives everybody crazy. Well, unless your team gets the turnover.
He might have gotten a yard at best.
It looked like the rush caused some problems there, Coach.
Yep, they were in there so quick that the running back was never able to get started.
They go with the option. They'll get him for a loss.
This kid is something special. You got to have a certain kind of mentality to play the linebacker position.
Man, is that ever true, Coach? If you want to be the best linebacker, you have to be able to do it all. Cover the receivers, bring down the running backs, take on blocks, rush the quarterback, and sometimes call the plays.
Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space.
Oh, boy. That is a nice play on third down. The quarterback found his receiver, and they connected on a big play.
Big? That's an understatement, Kirk. This completion keeps the kick team off the field and gives them a new set of downs.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. High formation here. Complete. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
You know, having a playmaker in tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
I don't really know what this one's for. Let's find out.
Holding on the offense.
He looked like he had a handful of jersey on that one.
Well, you can get away with a little holding, but hey, you can't do that.
They line up in a double tight set. Another run. He dances around, but they're still able to bring him down. The running back picks up a yard on the counter. It's second down and a long ways to go. Ball on the 43. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. And it's caught. And he's hammered down.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
They've got trips bunched on the left. The option left. They'll drop him for a loss. Good play by the defense. They broke up the option before it got started.
I'll tell you what, the quarterback has to be more decisive than that. Either get it to the back on the outside or take the ball, find a seam, and cut upfield.
And that defense is getting a little excited down there.
Encroachment. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 23. They motion to the left. That's a great tackle. At the 12-yard line. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
And they'll get him in the backfield. The offense calls a timeout. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Second down. They're packed in tight on the line. Fakes to the back. And he's going to come up with a sack.
He took too much time. You got to be more aware in the pocket.
It could have been worse, though. There was only a 1 yard loss on the play. They're changing the play. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Oh, man, he doesn't get the first. Great play by the defense.
Incredible. They saw that coming a mile away.
I think you've got to give your quarterback a little bit more time, especially on third down.
Yeah, there's no way that short stuff is going to work on these guys. Great play to bring up fourth down.
He gets it up. And it is good. That score leads us to our Pontiac drive summary. They line up to kick this one away. He sends it off. It's fielded at the 2. Made at the 29-yard line. They'll take over at the 29. There are four wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They'll run the option. Laterals back, and he's got space. And down he goes at the 46. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. The score here in Nashville is... Auburn, 14. Vanderbilt, 3. Auburn got the ball to start the game, so they'll be kicking off to start the second half. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 38. Well, before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They line up in the shotgun. He throws right.
And he can't make the catch.
Number seven, the intended receiver on the play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 38. Three wide receivers on the field. The quarterback in the shotgun. Runs it right and can't get away. Nice tackle. The running back gets a yard, maybe less. Third down and 10 coming up. They line this one up in the shotgun. Four wide receivers split out in the formation. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line.
He ran a clean route, and the quarterback got it to him with a good pass. First down.
And the receiver was able to shake off all the defenders that were trying to cover him, and that really made it easy for the quarterback to pick him out and throw him the ball.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 48. The defense is looking for the pass as they bring out their dime package. They'll work the right side. Tackle at the 50. A two-yard run by the halfback.
Gain of two.
The quarterback caused them to run out of room. Excellent play by him to keep it from going outside.
Makes the catch and look out. They get 5 yards on the play.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
The backfield's in an offset eye formation. Again, he'll get the call. And he's tackled around the 35-yard line. The defense is having a difficult time stopping this drive.
Right now, they're doing enough to be in situations they want to be in, but they have to finish the job. And the plays start to add up, so we'll have to see if this defense starts to look tired out there.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. And we got some fresh legs in there at tailback. And they motion a guy to the right. First down, looking to throw. Going right to his tailback. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
This is very well played by this linebacker. He stayed in his coverage and made a nice hit on the play.
They'll get two on that one.
The running back just didn't have any room to move, Kirk.
That's because the defense called the blitz at the right time. They were able to come after the running back before he went for big yards.
He'll go with the fullback. Makes it to the 21. Another carry for this kid, and he'll get the first down.
He's been pretty reliable on this drive, Kirk.
He's carrying this offense on his back right now. And I think they'll keep giving him the ball until the defense figures out a way to stop him.
First and 10. This is the 10th play of this drive. There are three wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They go with a run. Tackled for a loss.
That's the linebacker there getting in there to shut that play down.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. That's a 7-yard gain.
Guys, good read here by the quarterback to find the receiver. The receiver ran a little slant and was able to get just enough separation from the defender to allow the quarterback to fire it in there.
Throws a strike over the middle. An excellent pass to the wideout for six.
That wide receiver had his eyes on the end zone the second he caught the ball. That was a nice looking play.
This receiver sure makes it look easy. He ran a perfect post route to the middle of the field, and the defense just wasn't able to keep up.
He hits the PAT. And here's the Pontiac drive somewhere. Vanderbilt is ready to kick it away. He sends it off. They'll bring him down at the 38-yard line. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. Six DBs on the field for the defense. They'll throw on first down. He's got an opening. And they push him out around the 47-yard line. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Passes to the back, incomplete. He was wide open, guys.
They missed a big opportunity on this play. He had a guy open, but he just couldn't get him the ball.
Here's the option. And he tackles him hard at the 44. A big gain on the option.
I'm telling you right now, guys, the defense has to do a better job of keeping an eye on this young man. He shows he has the ability to hurt you.
And this is an offense that can do this to you every now and then.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. They line up in the shotgun. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. They're stopped 2 yards behind the line.
Great play by the defense. They were just sitting there waiting on the pass.
It's second down and 12 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Single set backfield. The junior makes the catch. And down he goes at the 35.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
The offense lines this one up in the shotgun with two tight ends. They go with a run. Scooped up by the defense. And that's a big defensive lineman who came away with that big play, fellas.
This guy will mix them up with the best of them. And this was just a great job of taking advantage of an offensive mistake.
And he shows a great nose for the football. He shed it off a block and then saw that it was a loose football, then he pounced on it.
They come out in a nickel. Around the 44-yard line.
Now, that's what I like to see. This first down came because this kid was not afraid to go over the middle. Nice job of beating the man coverage on this slant route.
They go with a run. Tackle made at the 46. Designed quarterback draw there, and it gets him about 2 yards. One man backfield. Play fake, gets away. Brought down around the 43-yard line. They pick up a few yards there on the pass.
And I'll tell you what, that fake handoff froze the secondary just enough to allow for the receiver to come up with a nice gain that time. Good call.
On the ground with the tailback. He's tackled at the 37. They pick up a good 6 yards there. Second and three. Ball on the 37-yard line. Hang on tight, folks. We head to the fourth quarter in what could be a shocker. The score here in Nashville is Auburn 14, Vanderbilt 10. Option. Tackle at the 36-yard line. Nothing there on the keeper. It's third and three. Ball on the 36-yard line. Three down linemen and two linebackers on the field in this defense. Complete. And they push him out at the 40. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Coach, what in the world happened there?
Let me say this. That is not how you draw up a pass play. And the coach is really mad. I'll bet you a lollipop that that doesn't happen again.
Coach, you got yourself a deal, my friend.
The kick is away. It's long enough. And he got it. He made that one by the skin of his teeth, fellas.
Yep. The kicker was holding his breath on that one. But all that matters is that he put those 3 points up on the scoreboard.
This guy knew he could make it from that distance. Otherwise, they wouldn't have taken a chance on the field goal.
Vanderbilt is ready to kick it away. Kicks it away. And down he goes at the 39. This offense was infected by the turnover bug their last time out. Let's see if they can hold on to the ball here.
The offense needs to be more careful on this drive, Kirk.
Especially since this defense is so good at taking advantage of mistakes.
They'll start at the 39-yard line. First and 10. They'll work from the shotgun. Runs right. Hit hard. I'd say he got 1 or 2 feet on that try.
1 yard gain on the play.
They line this one up in the shotgun. Four wide receivers split out in the formation. They go with the run. He's got an opening. Very good tackle in space. 7 yards there. It's third down and two to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. It's getting louder down in the field. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And down he goes. Around the 42-yard line.
Keep those chains moving. Just a simple out route that time, and it was enough to beat the zone defense.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42. They'll work from the shotgun. Batted away. And he threw that one up for grabs.
This is one of the things that drives a coach crazy. You don't want to do anything stupid. Make mental mistakes that may cost you the ball game.
They line up in a double tight set. He passes it. Tipped away.
The quarterback just floated that one up there.
Yep, and the defender made a great play getting his hands on the ball.
They line up in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. And they'll lose a yard there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They go with a run. Gets out to about the 21. The quarterback draw goes for about a yard, but that's it.
That was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Not much room there as they hand it off straight up the middle. So the halfback gets only two on the draw play. Three wide receivers on the field. The quarterback in the shotgun. They'll run the option. Pitches it. He's got the corner. Gets to about the 24-yard line. They don't pick up the first on that play.
Brad, that defense is saying, not so fast, my friend. You're not going to run that ball that easy.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He makes it to the 45-yard line. Picked up some good, solid yardage on that return.
Yo, that's not good for the old net punting average either.
They line this one up in the shotgun. Four wide receivers split out in the formation. Option right. He's tackled. At about the 47-yard line. The defense calls a timeout. There are four wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Tackle at the 47. The defense calls a timeout. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Going with the shotgun here. It's the running back who picks it up. He's into the open field. And he will score. So the one-point lead turns into a seven-point lead with an all-important extra point on the way.
We still have a little less than 2 minutes left on the clock. So even with an eight-point lead, this game isn't over.
Yeah, but it's going to be difficult because it's going to take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it up. But we've seen that happen many times before, and there's sufficient amount of time left on the clock.
Auburn up 7 points. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And now we're going to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Auburn to kick this one off. And this one's away. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Coach Herbie, what's your take right now?
This is obviously a big possession. They have to get the ball in the end zone right here.
And this is their last opportunity, Kirk. If they don't score here, then they can call it a night.
Throws, and it's knocked away.
That linebacker showed good awareness there.
This guy can do it all, Kirk. I'd take him on my team any day.
Second and 10. They're in the shotgun with three wide receivers. He's taken down at the 45. The quarterback just lasered that one down the field, Coach.
Yeah, the defender had no shot at breaking that pass up.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. They'll bring in their dime package. Looks for his running back, incomplete.
Wasn't able to hit his halfback on that one, Coach.
Yeah, he led him just a little bit too far in that play. He won't miss that pass very often.
Here we go.
It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go to the air. Around the 34-yard line. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line. But you always have to watch this guy because he's certainly capable of making big plays.
First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. They line this one up in the shotgun. Four wide receivers split out in the formation. He drops back. He's taken off. And he's level at the 24. So they keep him in the field of play, guys.
Yeah, good pickup here on the ground, but I bet the coach would have been happier if he was able to get out of bounds on that play to stop the clock.
Remember, the clock stops to move the chains, but it'll start up again once they are set. So they have to hurry up.
The offense lines this one up in the shotgun. Three wide receivers in the formation. They go with a run. They bring him down in the backfield.
Guys, when we were at practice this week, you kind of got the feeling that they might run a little no huddle. In fact, here it comes.
They're changing the play. Spikes the ball. It's third and long, and at this stage of this game, they probably have to go to the air. There are three wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires across the middle. Brought down at the 22-yard line. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Intercepted, and I think I can hear the fat lady sing.
That could be it, folks. That pick could be the straw that broke the camel's back.
Forget the camels or whatever the heck you just said. I want to know what that quarterback was thinking. Come on, scramble, get sacked, throw it away. Anything, anything, anything but an interception.
We We've got a first and 10.
Ball on their own 25.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And he takes a knee. The defense calls a timeout. It's second and 11. Ball on the 24-yard line. There are seven defensive backs on the field in this defense. He'll go down to one knee. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Auburn, 21. Vanderbilt, 13. And Lee, now as we take a look at our Pontiac game-changing performance, your final thoughts on this one.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. I wasn't expecting this game to be this close. Auburn really struggled in this football game, and they almost got beat by a team much worse than they are. But remember this, almost doesn't count in college football.
Well, folks, thanks for joining us for this production of NCAA Football 09. It's been